Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron, I hope you're having a great day in Jesus. We're going to look today like, why won't people repent in the book of Revelation? Now, if you are like pre-trib or even post-trib, a lot of times you believe that from Revelation 4 to Revelation 19 happens in a seven-year period. So there's a, like this huge amount of stuff occurring on planet Earth. I mean, you've got in one place, like a fourth of the world dies, another place a third of the world dies. And then it says this, let's for example, Revelation 9 verses 20 and 21. It says, and the rest of the men, this is right after a third of the world's population dies. It says, and the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Neither repented they of their murders, nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornication, nor of their thefts. And when you go to Revelation 16, you kind of get the same thing. Verses 8 through 11, or 8 and 11, it says in Revelation 16, this is the wrath of God poured out on man. It says, and the fourth angel poured out his vial upon the sun, and power was given unto him to scorch men with fire, and men were scorched with great heat. This is verse 9, and blasphemed the name of God, which hath power over these plagues, and they repented not to give him glory. I need to write myself a note here. And then verse 11, it says, and blasphemed the God of heaven because of their pains and their sores, and repented not of their deeds. Well, I mean, I guess it's like, why didn't Pharaoh ever repent, you know? Why didn't Judas? He repented himself, but he didn't really repent in any real sense. So, I mean, so people deeply corrupt themselves from God. They get so far away from God. And, you know, I think in some cases they're taught theories of origins where God's not involved, atheistic philosophies, that they become militantly and stridently atheistic and say there's no God to repent to. And unfortunately, like, I can kind of see this. You may can too. In observing in the world, you know, that it used to be when tragedy happened, 9/11, all this, there was a mass repentance. Everybody comes to God. And but I mean, here it's like people are mad at God. They're just like, we're not going to repent. So it's because their hearts and their minds are so far away from God. They've gone through the Romans 1 paradigm. They become reprobate, and they have all those, 23 attributes of verses 28 through 32. Not only do those things, but have pleasure in them that do them. And some people have said it's because God's Spirit is not here drawing men to repentance as well. And that could play a factor also. So God bless. I'll talk with you later in Jesus' name. Live for God.